Bearded Science Guy here, and today we've got another hot and cold experiment, but this one turns out a little differently, in a way some people don't expect. The first thing you'll need is two glasses that are exactly the same size, some hot water, a thin, flat, hard piece of plastic, some oil-based food coloring, some water-based food coloring, and some baby oil. Start by pouring the hot water into one of the glasses. Fill it up all the way to the very top, where the water is actually bubbling up above the rim of the glass. After that, fill the other glass with cold baby oil the same way. I used a refrigerator to chill my baby oil, but you could use ice or any other method. Now it's time to add your food coloring. I chose red for the hot water and blue for the cold baby oil, but it doesn't really matter what colors you choose. What matters is using an oil-based food coloring for the baby oil and a water-based food coloring for the hot water. Now you need to stir in your food coloring, and stirring in the oil-based food coloring was pretty satisfying to watch. Once you're ready, now it's time to take the flat, rigid piece of plastic and slide it on top of the cold baby oil. Be careful though, this step doesn't always go according to plan, and that's why I recommend doing it in a large bowl or sink. Carefully flip the cold baby oil upside down, place it exactly on top of the hot water, and carefully slide the piece of plastic out. You'll notice that unlike the traditional hot versus cold experiment, where we use hot and cold water, the fact that we used baby oil allows the cold baby oil to stay on top of the hot water. When the water particles are at a high temperature, they're moving faster and pushing further away from each other, so they take up more space than when the water particles are at a lower temperature. However, the density of water is drastically different than the density of baby oil. So even though hot water has a lower density than cold water, this change in density is very small and doesn't even come close to the difference between baby oil's density and water, which is about 80% as dense as water. We can even flip this experiment upside down, and because of the polar-nonpolar nature of water and baby oil, they stay completely separated, and the baby oil ends up back on top again. Now let's take a look at this experiment with a thermal infrared camera. Now it's important to note that the thermal infrared camera can't see through glass, so what it's going to be looking at is the wavelength of infrared light coming off of the outside of the glass. And this is going to be directly related to the temperature of the glass. And when we flip them upside down, you'll notice that the hot water transfers heat energy to the cold glass faster than the hot glass transfers heat energy to the cold baby oil. But after we speed up the video, we notice that the water still has a much higher temperature than the baby oil, according to the thermal camera. I do find it interesting to note that the thick piece of glass retains its heat energy much longer than the thin walls of the glass.